some say the moon. Why climb the highest mountain? We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
What's up, everybody? You're in the building with Uncle Mont on the Life Games channel. Here's a movie, Streamer to Beam It review, first man. I was excited about this movie, but let's just say that I had the climax a little early, and I'll explain to you what happened with this movie in this video. If you're finding me for the first time, please go ahead, subscribe to my channel, click the notification bell, so that every time I drop a Life Games video, you are down. Life Gain Videos covers how you can make gains in every area of your life, and saving money at movies is one way to do it. Let's jump into it right now. What's up, everybody? You back in the building with your old Uncle Mont, and we're doing Life Gains movie reviewing, streaming or beam it. Trying to save you some money on those theater bills, letting you know if the movie is good or not. Let's jump into it. But first, as always, I got to put on the plus seven glasses of cinema sexy as hell, because we working on skilling up this craft, giving you that better YouTube experience, something better to look at. Video sponsors today, that tactical pen. Y'all need to go and grab one. That pen is a surgical knife. It can cook bacon. It has a laser. And when I say it can cook bacon, I mean if you get attacked by somebody, you can fry their ass with that pen. It does that. And for my folks working on getting fit, check out that two-week diet. So First Man is a movie that is talking about Neil Armstrong making it to the moon. It stars Ryan Gosling, who I really like because he never overacts. You know, he's not a rah-rah actor. He's kind of even-keeled. Some people might would even call him stoic. This movie is directed by Damien Chazelle. I don't know a lot about his work because I'm kind of new to this whole thespian approach to reviewing movies. But it also has Claire Foy, Kyle Chandler, Pablo Schreiber, and Corey Stowe. I hope I didn't butcher y'all name too bad. I know y'all gonna want to cuss me out. But this is not your traditional space movie. And as y'all can see, I am definitely a space case. I'm a nerd. And if Andre Black Nerd didn't take that name, I would have named myself that. But I love things dealing with space, science, what is out there besides just Earth. And if you go into the theater thinking that they're going to focus on that with this movie, you're going to be sadly mistaken. This movie's heavy focus is on Neil Armstrong himself, his dynamic with his family, all the things that was going wrong on Earth before they even got to the launch. That's the bread and butter of this movie. The tension from his wife not knowing if he's going to come back, the kids not knowing if he's going to come back. His daughter, a lot of people don't know, had some medical issues that they had to work out. And it's just a bevy of all the issues going on Earth before they get into outer space. So let's just talk about what was good with this movie. Ryan Gosling and the other cast, I mean, the acting is immaculate. I mean, you're not going to see better acting in this type of movie than what you would have got from the cast that they had in this movie. They just did an outstanding job. The family focus that they tried to put on this movie was really good. The special effects in this movie was great. And when they finally did get to space and they was in the ship, it felt like you were sitting in that ship. There was times when this thing was taking off, it felt like it was gonna rattle apart. And if you're in the theater, you felt like you was in that ship and the ship was gonna fall apart. The CGI in this movie was wonderful. They didn't overtouch anything. When they got to the moon, it really looked like they was on the moon. Some of those scenes were the most amazing you're gonna ever see. And one thing that did happen on the moon, I'm not gonna spoil it, but Neil Armstrong done something. Now, I don't know if this was theater play or if it really happened. Haven't found anything that said that this happened. But for those of you that have seen the movie or know what I'm talking about, leave me a comment. He done something on that moon that you never hear in the history books. And I'm just curious if this really happened. So that might entice you to want to go see the movie, but I'm not sure if this was real or if it was just theatrical play. Here's the bad part about the movie, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, if you're going there because you want to see what, you want to take your mind in space, don't go there for that reason. The movie is extremely long. I felt like they could have cut this thing maybe 30, 40 minutes short. And a lot of time is spent on Earth. You know, those are the drawbacks to this movie. The script is fine. The actors did a great job. But the movie is really, really long. And at the end of the day, I kind of feel like you don't get emotionally invested in Neil Armstrong. I think it kind of feels like the only thing you care about with him is what he does when he gets to the moon. All the things going on Earth, they don't grab you. They don't make you jump into the movie, you know. And having said all those things about this movie, ladies and gentlemen, I give it 6 out of 10 because if you're a space lover, I don't feel like it's going to satisfy your itch. If you're someone who likes to see family drama, family dynamic, you know, things that lead up to a climax, then maybe this is your movie. But on the life gain scale, 6 out of 10, that's as best I can give it. And you guys know that if it's not 7 or higher, I always say you might as well wait and stream it when it becomes available on your favorite streaming apparatus. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video, comment, and subscribe. Go get yourself a life gain. Just wait and stream this one. I love Ryan Gosling, but he's not going to be able to overcome the overall experience of what this movie is. It's just too expensive if you got a family of 10 and 5 baby mamas. This movie ain't gonna work for you. And until that next sexy as hell video, I'll see you.